Oh man, these allegiance halls. I forgot how cool they were. They were a bit of a late addition in the last run of the game. One of my favorite things to do to them. Bam! The triple debuff. These were really sprawling buildings. Back halls were always fun. When I was in the Covenant, our old allegiance, we would have our allegiance meetings back here in this room. This is where all the action happened. The officers would stand up here and on the stage, and we would all crowd around down here. I have screenshots of all this. Oh, I need to turn my phone down. This is really ridiculous. Really well-made buildings. Of course, this is the White Bay Allegiance Hall, where no one ever was. I wonder. I've really gotta wonder. I don't remember. Everybody always used the allegiance halls of the continent that was farthest along for them. So if you had kind of a newbie allegiance, you would put your allegiance hall on Icarus. Or if you had a normal one, you would put it in Undecoto. After all these years, I'll never remember what the right way is when going to these portals. If I play for a while, I get to knowing it. So for several weeks I'll be okay, and then I'll stop playing and forget when I come back. So I'll always try to get from this set of portals to this set of portals, but I'll end up down here because it all looks the same. Alright, so this is Arhovis, which I think had one quest based out of it. And Onokoto had a lot of, it was a better central hub to all the other towns, because it had quests in town. You could get to Tukal, which was the actual hub, even though it was bigger, so people didn't prefer it. Gurkura would take you to Givoth. palisades. Pally. That was a high level hunting area back in the day. Change. I always thought these were weird. Open skies. Lighting in this game wasn't perfect. I actually need to let someone know that I'm streaming. Okay, back to it. So I don't really know what I'm going to be doing today. I don't think the guys that I was playing with last week are playing at the moment. Scholar. I would love to run boots one last time. I would love to run boots one last time. Levels higher than you, man. I'll have to do a little bit of crafting later, too. Kind of get a feel for how that looked. Get one of my alts to be a starter for IF and just run IF for no reason at all. IF being ice fire. Whatever. Those ledges. So tricky. Horrid beetles. Oh, Jesus. They were so strong. Didn't even make sense. Level 50 beetles that just hit so fast and so hard. Lodrog the Forsaken. Hunting for revenant prefects so they could drop their bones. Pretty rare. That drop rate sucked. Even the spawn rate of prefects was terrible. Doom sharks. I like reed sharks, but doom sharks were just dangerous. Jiggly's Rufflestein, what's up? How you doing, B? welcome to the stream. It's another chill stream where I wax eloquently about a game that's not going to exist in 2 weeks. Signs weren't nearly as helpful as I think they were intended to be. What's even weirder is I never came out here. Oh my, people on Pyreal. Hi. Please select. Didn't know that legionaries were out here. Wish I'd have known that. This is a really nice, grinding place, it looks like. Just for legionaries alone. Shit. Normally you'd have to go out to outside of the to Cowering Way, the I forget what that region was called, the Thusic Ringway, I think. All kinds of revolutionaries out here, or revolutionaries, legionaries. Tons of them out here. That's awesome. Tiglis. Not much, just relaxing, thinking what to write for my workshop. This class, I have to write 20 pages a week. This includes, like, critiques as well, so whatever. How many pages a story is, the rest is critiques. Ugh, it sounds like literal hell to me. I hate writing. You give me a 5-page paper, and I'll give you the stink eye. Oh, I forgot about those. They added a patch at one point back in the day where it was some kind of portal quest where in all the, well, not all, but in a lot of these Ringway outposts, there would be a portal beacon that is completely invulnerable to damage. And it would be surrounded by an unimaginable number of that continent's adversarial race. In this case, the Gurog with the entire continent of Linvak. This was a really neat opportunity if you knew what you were doing. Obviously, walking near there would be death, even for me, being 10 levels above everything in there. But if you had a tactician with grape shot, maybe two tacticians with grape shot, you would just set up your turrets right here, toss a wrench in, and watch the turrets do their thing. And if you could do it right, you could get ridiculous numbers of experience just by doing that. It sounds like hell. I hope in the end it'll be worth it because the professor describes it as affirmation. Yeah. That would do it. I don't think that sounds good at all. Hunting Fets for XP, 2 level 17s and an 81 Chanter, if anyone wants to join. You don't get a whole lot of experience for Fets at that level. You have to do the Shreth around the undead area and zoo at that level, at least by my experience. The fetish experience isn't very good there. Dakota, Gurakura. Jeez. Oh, I might be too choked up to play this game today. I thought I was upset last week. This is really upsetting. Alright, so that ringway walked me to, I think this is Arhovis. like the actual city of Arhovis. No, it's the city of Gurukura. That's really funny. Huh. These cities were pretty pointless in this game. I think with more time they could have been something really neat. Huh, there were prefects out here too. I never knew where to find the revenants that I wanted. The Linvak Armory was nice for that. I think it had all three types. We might have to check that out later. Malthabor. Oh, jeez. Malthabor Vault. This is the only character I've ever finished the entire vault set. Oh my god, the monthly events. So many of those I didn't get to experience. September 2004. This was the first patch after I quit. Jiggly says, hold on. Through the ages of Dareth, many champions have fought for the cause of light. Few have equaled the strength, the righteousness, or the rage of Auntona. The invincible Tumurok warlord has sworn to destroy the shadowy Huaru and all who serve him. Yet some, like Nalikana, are beginning to see in Auntona more than a desire for justice. They see a soul-devouring hunger for vengeance. And hunger is the domain of Huaru. That's cool. But yeah, they had these little cutscenes, slideshows, really. Every month, up until they weren't monthly anymore. You can really see when they stopped caring about this game. No October update. No December update. No February. No April. It was every other month until they hit July. And then in September or October, I forget which, they killed it off. I never got to redo Edpil's Vengeance, and that makes me sad. That quest was hard as crap, and I remember getting stuck on the ceiling when I ran it back in the day. Took a ton of screenshots of it, though. Prologue. But yeah, I did all the vaults on this character. I should have recorded it, but I didn't know there was software that could do that when I played through it the first time. And my computer probably couldn't have handled it anyway. Although that computer was a lot more than it was needed to play this game. East Gavoth Outpost. And Jiggly says, in said workshop, I'm like the youngest in the sense I'm a third year versus everyone being fourth or fifth year. Wow. Fifth year? I thought those degrees usually only lasted four. I mean, mine's gonna last about three. Not gonna make it to my goal. In 2019, I hoped to be standing in, well, another country. I hope to already be out. I set that as my goal back in May of this year. I don't think I'm going to make it. Some people take more than 4 years to finish, yeah. If I continue with my current course load, I won't be able to finish in the amount of time. It would be expected to get a degree. Alright, I just picked up a black dye plant. Apparently people aren't farming this place nearly as much these days. This is a really popular hunting area. Mobile groups would walk all around here. It's a dangerous spot. To the brave entrepreneurs of grinding mad experience, you could run into the frozen ravine past all these jerks. When they added all those guys who stand around that portal, I remember just being so angry. Because it was like, okay, I just found out about this place. Now it's impossible to get in here? You're kidding me, right? So there's a singularity trove. Anytime I get singularity keys, I would kind of gather them up and hold on to them. And then I would set up a tacked camp right outside there and just farm them. While looting that sing chest. I got some pretty neat stuff out of there. So this door was one of those weird, like, late game portals that they were like, oh, we're gonna set up portals that don't have a cool effect. A cool transition. So there were two Shreth in there, very angry. Easy to bypass. There's a Shreth down there, very angry. Less easy to bypass, but generally not a threat. I don't remember what was down here, but this is not where we need to go. I don't remember what was down here because there's nothing down here. Yeah, this is Frozen Ravine, and this is where it turns into the Shreth hideout. There used to be a long, buggy, horrible quest chain through here, where you would go through and do some nonsense, and, you know, that was it. Well, then they changed the quest entirely. They made it to where... Oh, damn it. Of course I aggroed you. Why wouldn't I? Yeah, then they changed the whole quest where you would start here, you'd find a note from the people you were trying to kill saying basically, oh yeah, no, we're not here. Everybody go to the new base, and then you'd have to go halfway across this continent to the new base. And that was dumb. It made this quest really confusing, but when they redesigned it, it was better, I guess. And what I find most interesting is that this whole area is full of these carnage shreths, which are super farmable. You can set up a tactician camp in the corner of this big room, and there's about 6 or 7 spawns that would just constantly regenerate. And if you timed things right and you had a capable, knowledgeable group, it was pretty incredible. All these side rooms, man. Better living through wealth distribution. Heroes, not villains. It's not theft, it's sharing. I really feel like the writers of this were really just taking a piss. They just didn't care. We don't care how ridiculous it is. We're just gonna add a plot about communists in this game. It's not an acronym. Yeah, they didn't. They really didn't care. Don't ask what it stands for. And I honestly don't know why that's a joke. Don't ask what it stands for. I don't get the joke. Oh, lag. Do you remember how to get out of here?
Only vaguely. God, I'm lagging really bad today. Man, look at all of them. I have to set up a tact camp in there today. For old time's sake. Get my other dudes in here. Don't know why I'm walking through frozen ravine with really no purpose. Not like anything's happening here. So much I want to show on video, but I don't know what order to do it in, or even how I'm gonna cover everything. Cause like, at this point it's just like showing you a hollow shell of what used to be. No one's here doing the things. Yeah, the exit from Frozen Ravine is kind of a joke, so we're gonna portal recall out of here. This will take me to my last used portal, which is, well, other than the dungeon portals, which can't be recalled, generally. There are a few exceptions. It'll take you back to your last ringway, usually. Or if your town portal. Give off ringway to Palisade. I should probably cast all my buffs. Palisade was the city for Givoth Ringway, and it was a PvP area. Well, KvK area, I believe, it technically was. I don't remember if it was free-for-all or KvK, but point is, it was player conflict area, so there would usually be tacticians or elementalists with auto pets sitting right here waiting for you to portal in if you accidentally did. Or not accidentally, you know, sometimes people would come in and actually look for a fight. Even when this game came back, nobody really did that. PvP was pretty much a dead concept. Nobody took up kingdoms. Like, back in the day, there used to be mad trash talk in the general channel between Dominion and Order. And sometimes Shadow. Actually, no, Shadow had a good representation. Yeah, Order was the most popular, Shadow was the most successful, and Dominion had the loudest trash talkers. And they were so good at it, holy shit. That was on Harvest Gain, my old server. Alright, so let's buff ourselves, eh? The glow of weapons was always really nice in these winter scenes. I think one of the most... You're gonna hear a lot of buff noises now. One of the coolest things that I remember from when I started playing this game back in 2003 was they would actually change the world periodically in their updates, and they would completely redo the seasons, like... manually, they would change it. So Osteth, the human continent, would be changed to winter, and when I started playing, it was winter for about a month or two. And I remember it was so much fun because we would walk through, like, these rivers. They were listed as rivers on the map, but they were frozen over. And you could get to places that, during normal water, wouldn't be as easy, because they were canyons on both sides. But when it's essentially become a glacier, you can run across it. And I remember very clearly, it was a night, I had this party of noobs, and we just saw this dungeon on the map, and we were like, hey, let's go see what's in this dungeon. We didn't have a quest that made us go there. We knew there was no boss who was going to give us mad loot. This wasn't that kind of game. But we wanted to do it, just for the sake of exploration. And I remember I had just found one of my first glowing enchanted weapons, and it was just kind of cool to wash the lighting off of the snow, which, again, was just all poorly textured white ground, but it was fucking cool. It was really cool. See, this is all that PvP-controlled area where they have these high-level golems. It don't make any sense, because not many people were that high level around here. I guess it was to stir up the PvPers, but I don't know why they did any of that. I never did find out if these guys were good for farming experience. Level 61, they'd be a little bit higher than my tact camp could handle. And I don't know if neutrals can actually farm them like that. Titanium golems. Yeah, this might hurt. I got really close to them. I'm actually going to bounce over to, I think, Aramora. Oh god damn it. I'm retarded. Get the hell out of here. No, let's just summon Portal 2. Back to Pally. Pally was weird in that, the city portal would take you to the ringway portal, but the actual portals were on, like, the opposite end of this little area. Pain in the butt to accidentally end up here. On the map. I know Gurakura, there was something significant about it. It had, out on the ringway, Malthabor. Yeah, okay. I remember this. They had the hero quest. At least the base of the hero quest was here. I'm trying to remember what that dungeon even was. I think it was the Fortress Gorata. No. It was down here. Shadow Thrall. Yeah, this was another KVK area. I couldn't participate. Because I'm a filthy neutral. I'm trying to remember exactly where this thing was. Yeah, I went too far out. Okay, here we go. Fortress Goarkta is like way up there. Up on the mountain. So the place that I'm going isn't on the map, because this was added in the hero update. The Great Gate. Back for more. Yeah, I'm back for more. Archon's holding, that's it. Yeah, baby. No requirements for use. Fascinating. Either way. If you drop a thigh bone, I swear to God. Oh good, no thigh bones. I'm safe. Yeah, this dungeon was really annoying. It was three-phased, because the hero quest was three-phased, but each phase became more and more of a maze. And it's like once you memorize it, you run through the quest once or twice, you'll have it memorized, but trying to get people through it was always a challenge. Yeah, Fortress Goarkta. I ran up here once if I recall. Damn it. Tons of Urog up here. I tacticianed this spot for a while. Before realizing there were better spots to tactician camp. You'll probably come back here now and just run train. Because those guys are much higher level now. Back for more. I really want to see King of the Mountain, damn it. Don't attack me. I just want to see the King of the Mountain. He's a huge Gurog and he's angry. He's got two axes. Another victim approaches. See on the map, we're just above that fortress. And on the map, we're just above the hero stronghold. The ridiculous jumps that could be softened by landing on the cliffside. The rubber banding. Glad I got rubber banding on. My recording here. Fetid Percher. I'm gonna murder you. I think you were the assholes from the, Boots quest. The Boots and Cats and Boots and Cats and... Jigglies, if you're still there, I hope you're having fun. I'm just kind of waxing eloquently about a game I love. That's all I'm doing. Really not much else to it. Not much else I can do. As you can see from the chat in the general channel there, that most people have pretty much given up on actually playing the game and they're just kind of romping around, much like I am right here. Stop healing yourself and die faster. More damage. Debuffs. I forget what those were called, but if the target glows orange, you can do your base class ability and it'll do extra damage based on what level you have that skill at. You're still watching. Well, that's good. I did a lot of homework last night, so I'm kind of, you know, feeling that boat you're in where you're doing work. I was watching AGDQ and doing Business 101. Not the most fun class, but it's online. It's my first ever online class. If you jump while looting a corpse, it loots faster. Speedrun strats. If you're targeting an enemy and you cast a heal, it heals yourself. Most games do that, but it was convenient in this game. Well, let's do this. The second part of the Shreth quest was here. So that was the Hero Stronghold, where you did the Hero Quest. I think there was another quest you could do from there, but I don't remember what it was. The center of this area, you can see on the map, if you're looking at any amount of detail, there's this little ridge of kind of... it's a Bloodstone module. Why is that sitting there? Never seen those spawn on the ground. I don't think they do. Someone must have dropped it. Ebon Pyreel. But yeah, in this little ridge, there is a tyrant nest. The whole thing's just a tyrant nest. There's a Gurog in there, jeez. The tyrant is very unhappy. Nesting tyrant, that's it. Yeah. Look at how angry it is, level 60 and angry. And it will follow you across this whole place. It doesn't care. They hit hard, and they hit powerfully. And their range is wider than your radar. Someone was dropping Bloodstone modules all around here. Nodules, I said modules. Grog henchmen. Revenant lictors, they were tough. Tough as nails, bruh. I think killing them would give you seals to the Mage Academy. Which I think I have a bunch on this character. Yeah, seal of the Academy. Break the seal to gain entry into the Mage Academy beneath Mount Malthabur. Jiggly says, I have an idea for a story in my head involving, like, a weird point system and children, just trying to think of what to go from there. Well, good luck. I'm not much a writer myself. We played Pathfinder yesterday, which is like D&D. It pretty much is D&D. But, my Eastern kind of Japanese-Chinese theme campaign had kind of gotten stale a little bit for me because, you know, not a whole lot was happening. All the ideas that were fun to me seemed really far away. But my players kind of jump-started the plot. They jumped farther ahead than I thought they'd be, and they actually learned a lot more about the story than I thought they would get. So I actually had a lot of fun playing yesterday. Alright, so here we go. Somewhere down there on the beach is a portal. The portal takes you to a random spot. I think it's technically a dungeon, even though it looks like an island. Yeah, that ambient blowing sound was a character on a different account that I had a window open for. It's not just an ambient sound that always plays. Whereas the chimes are indeed from that another separate account. Jiggly says, also wondering how I can how I'm doing a 20, doing 20 a week, doing three stories and that one final. And the three also has three has these assignments, which in a way we do the stories in another person's POV or a different setting. That's really neat. See, it sounds fun, but super challenging. I'm not a wordy writer. I spent a decade writing technical specs, manuals, and, you know, case notes. So we all teach ourselves to be very brief. You know, you use only the necessary language, and then you hit send. God, I'm gonna miss this game. Can't say it enough. Mysterious portal, that's it. I can recall this portal. That's hilarious. Yeah. And we're out here in the middle of nowhere. Oh, it's not a dungeon, so it is actually just out in the ocean. It's cool that they added something like that. I wonder if, with enough stamina, you could swim here. Reminds me of the Hero Island. Aramora. Alright, these things are getting dangerous. Getting too dangerous. I gotta pull out. I gotta get out of here. Claustrophobia setting in. Oh no. I just wanted to see a part of the island that nobody ever went to. Oh god, I'm dead. Yeah, those things hit like trucks. I'm not dead. I thought it was gonna rubber band me back again. How convenient that it didn't. You can walk through a portal and it'll teleport you. Or you can hit F on the portal and then your character will use it and you will be teleported. To heal, vigor heal, and then Linvak to call, recall.
Oh my god. Just trying to imagine losing this game again, and it's mind blowing. That was an interesting sound effect. That might have been the Verindi there. I really gotta wonder if they ever bring this game back again. I was taking a bit of video before I started my stream, and as soon as I logged in, I saw in the general channel they were talking about, I guess it was a petition or a survey about bringing the game back, apparently there's a group of about 20 people who are doing their best to try to get this game back. And I find it really interesting that it's not so much that they're just trying to bring it back, they're trying to keep both Asheron Skull 1 and 2 alive. Oh man, if they could do that, I wouldn't even know what to do with myself. The post on Facebook does go in and say that it's not likely they'll be able to get Asheron Skull 2, but could possibly get Asheron Skull 1. And if that would be the case, I, again, wouldn't even know what to do with myself. Time and it just kind of, as soon as I quit the first window, the second one took over. Cool. So this is another character on another account. Is that Buckler? Jeez. Soulbound Sword of Linvak. I always liked, this is the starting human town, Arwick. Most characters would end up here to start the quest chain anyway. The warder. Warders of Osteth quest chain. I would always just hang out here while AFK. Now this character is level 47, part of a team of a 3-box that I had going. Around the time I quit was around the time that they were just starting to get to a point where they could start doing Frozen Ravine on their own. And I had a lot of people that were tagging along for that, and that was always really fun. Should probably summon my pet. Yeah. Level 51. Yeah. Level 158? What's my armor level? 185. I've got better armor without my shield than my pet. But the pet's 4 levels higher than me, so he has natural, ridiculous evasion. So, human characters would start up on the top of that mountain, and there was a long ramp down into the city. And, yeah. This is the path to the Arwick Mines. I always remember, this is just such a big deal for farming. Yeah, get wrecked. You get wrecked. Arwick Outlands glyph. I don't remember. I don't think I did many of the vaults on these characters, so I should go back and do some of the Omishan vaults on stream. I could solo them easily on this character. Oh, I should definitely do Toto Vault today. I'll do Toto Vault on this guy. Just show how bad it was. That's a really nice weapon I just looted. Well, I just turned to gold. Jarring. There was something nice about this game. It didn't care what weapon you equipped unless it was a specialty weapon from an advanced class. But my sorcerer could equip a bow at any point. Wouldn't be able to use a lot of their abilities, but they could do it. And to a certain point, bow proficiency is decent. You just can't hit the higher level stuff. Proficiency system in this game was pretty neat. it wasn't at all complicated. I'm a magician. I just master all my magic, get the paragon, and then I'm good. And that was really as complicated as it got. I think I have... Leader of the pack, yeah. That's a run buff. I spec'd this character specifically for Leader of the Pack, which made no sense. But, you know, I like running fast. Actually, no, that's a Feral Intendant skill, so it made sense. I don't know what I'm talking about. Wait, isn't... Leader of the Pack... I guess I don't know. Oh, Leader of the Pack, yeah. I spent 2 skill credits on it, that's not a big deal. RIP! My pet sounds like a monster is chasing me at all times. Cutter Beetle. One of those annoying enemies that just always drops an item that you can't loot. Yeah, get wrecked. What? That's awesome! Ord of Piercing. A low-level orc, just out of nowhere. Huh. Orts were one-time use weapon buffs. Looks like this one was one of the permanent ones, too. It was low-level, clearly, but still pretty freaking cool. A weapon with the power of piercing. Reduces a target's health by 5 points per second for 15 seconds. A lot of people are dropping their gear in the middle of nowhere and then walking off. Who can blame them? I wouldn't be surprised if we saw a lot of cool stuff like that just laying around. Oh, I put Shrethbane on this sword. That was a smart move. It soul binds it, but you know, whatever. Alright, so this thing has piercing now. Good. It has a durability to it, so it'll eventually wear off. I have it frosty. Oh man, I gotta get there. To go to Cragstone. I'm gonna get back on my other character who can get me there quickly. Did I bug the game out and it thought I was still using the drum? Flagged himself for PvP, I see. Oh, accidentally hit quit on the launcher. The Frostbound one. Find the Frostbound one. I don't remember specifically where he was. Pretty sure he was off of Arhovas. The Winter Hollows. funny thing about memory. Years later, I'm going to try watching these videos and possibly cry my eyes out. And I'm going to think, well, gee, that's not how you did that. Or, gee, I don't remember it like that. Memory's a funny thing. Alright, cool. So this is indeed where I need to be. Cyborg. They're all heroes. I don't know if they'll need a debuffer, but you know. I'll go along. I don't have a lot of gold for mounts, jeez. Oh, these mounts were fast. Ephemeral Sarah Atur. I remember this walk too well. I could probably do it in my sleep. Yeah, Zarm just said, hello Dareth, any level 37-ish stuff going on? Those were horrible, horrible levels. Level 37, the run-up to it. 37 in the original release was the worst level for me. Just killed my pet, so it won't pool. Unnecessary aggro, as they tend to do. Quest is so much fun. Can't wait to do it.
Quest received.
Okay, that's ice fire. Frostbound One can give you the power to destroy Rytherin in exchange for a service. So we did GA and AP last week. With the weapon you get from AP, you can finish this quest, and by doing GA, you can start this quest. Or no, by doing Law Drugs, which we didn't do because it's terrible, you can start this quest. He doesn't have any of the stuff he needs. Crap. Oh well. Reaps are essentially a self-heal. That's why it's my most leveled ability. It's actually a really cool thing. It takes health from your target. So you hit them with it, and it hurts them, and it heals you. Should have come down and debuffed this thing. I don't think it's going to be necessary. I mean, it might be necessary, but, you know. Ooh, I avoided the dangerous move somehow. The knockback, the big hit. Yep, this is happening. Man, when I have two windows open, the one that I'm not recording always gets pretty good. Rip me. Window around if you needed. Also, made it back just in time to go back to Cragstone. Buffer. Run speed is pretty much as good as my mount speed, considering I have to pay for every mount. Mr. Flair. I'm too good for that. Dangerous. Oh, jeez. Prefects. Time to wreck crap. Like, really and truly, just wreck things. Stuff.
Quest at best.
So the idea is that you kill the Behemorn Gigarath, and then you go and you loot him, and from that loot there is an oil that you give to the Frostbound one. It advances the quest, and he grants you access to the Icefire Gorge. Vial of Behemorn oil to the Frostbound one. We'll stop following and we're gonna kill this jerk. Is that another sorcerer? No, you're a channeler. You don't count. I'm a thaumaturge, baby. I'm dangerous.
Quest advanced.
Level 70 chanter, though. I don't have anything I can dip. How much experience do I need to level? Ugh, 69 million. I'm gonna get, I think, 15 from this? Yeah, Ritherin's Bane. Greatsword of the Ancients. I can dip. Holy crap. May as well dip.
Quest completed.
15 million, baby. So now I have Greatsword of the Sun's Blaze. Because we're gonna blaze it. That's funny that I just happen to be able to.
Oh man, IF was always just fun, silly, and easy. Okay, so that's IF. Man, I'm glad I got to do that. That was fun. Okay. Wet fur. I forget what that does. So targeted skill covers user in a shield, causing attackers to slow down when they attack. That's cool as hell. It's probably water-based. Water and... like, it doesn't stack with still water. So the first fight, it made sense that I used it. The second one, I don't think I used it, but if I did, it wouldn't have helped. Shades of the Lost Heroes. I don't remember that one. He's already a hero. Oh well. Drudge Manifesto Delivery. Oh, that's a low level nonsense thing. Isle of Tears Drudge Fort. That's a nightmare quest. It's recommended level 12. If you do that at level 12, you're gonna have a very poor time of it. Oh my god. I don't want to take a break. I think that was a good, let's see, hour. I will be back later for more of this. We'll see what happens. If something fun jumps up in the game, I'll start the stream back up. Jigglies, if you're still there, keep on rocking. And I'll catch you very soon. Anyone else who might be there, I hope you enjoyed this little bit. But for sure this time, I will be back later today. Can't wait to see you all then. Bye.